Hey guys, it's May 13th, 2016, and the garden is doing very, very well. It seems to have taken off in the last couple of weeks, and I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a garden update. So we're starting off a little bit differently today, so we're on the opposite end of the garden. And we will start off with our pluot. So we put this pluot in a couple weeks ago, three, 4 weeks ago, and it seems as though it has started to some new growth on its leaves, so that's awesome. I'm very, very happy about that. So it means that it's rooted in well. It's not suffering from any shock that from the transplant from the bucket to here, and it's taken off really, really well. All right, now here are the eggplants. But in addition to the eggplants, you'll also notice in this bucket there are some other things. This is going to be a recurring theme for this episode throughout the entire garden, in every single bed. I'm serious, guys. You remember last garden update, right before then, I had gone ahead and put down some compost. Well, it was homemade compost, and the seeds from the fruits and whatnot that I threw in there didn't burn up completely. And that means that some of them were still viable seeds. And when I threw in the compost, after a couple days, this happened about a week ago, these guys started coming out. There's a whole bunch of different kinds of things. From what I can tell, they're either pumpkins, cantaloupes, or watermelons. And in this bucket alone, there's four of them. So there's one there, and then there's three over there. So I'm just gonna let them grow. They honestly are serving no harm. It's actually kind of cool, because I wasn't expecting to have watermelons this year, but some of these guys, or pumpkins for that matter, but some of these guys are watermelons and pumpkins. So that's awesome. And here are our eggplants. Now this guy's got some holes in him. I don't know if that comes from a bug or whatnot, but otherwise he seems to be doing well. He's got some new growth coming out right here, new baby leaves. And then this guy as well, he's doing well. It seems like he's got one yellow leaf, but otherwise he's doing really great. So the eggplants, they're growing slower than I think they did last year, but they're still growing, so I'm happy about that. Okay guys, now we get to the quince. These guys are actually pretty significant in size now. So I would say ping pong ball. Yeah, ping pong ball. Let me see if I could get it in the sun so I could show you guys. Yeah, you guys could see it right there. So that's cool. And there's quite a few of them on here. I think a couple fell off, but otherwise there might be like two dozen on here. Maybe 18. All right guys, we'll get to the apricots in a bit, but first onto the tomatoes. So these are the tomatoes in zone one. They're not as big as the zone two tomatoes that are over there, because those are crazy. But these guys are doing great nonetheless. Recently they seem to have started taking off. I really haven't touched these guys a whole lot. I just come out and water them. I haven't even been putting them inside their cage where they should be. So like this guy should be inside of his cage. But yeah, they seem to be only growing. They're not putting out any fruit. Obviously they have the flowers here, but for these guys especially, I think the flowers just kind of fall off. They haven't put on any fruit yet. So that's that. All right, guys. And these were the... Yeah, these were the Beefmasters and the Big Beef, I think. Yeah. Beefmasters in the back. Okay, now on to the apricots. Some of them are already turning yellow. You'll see this giant arm here is turning yellow. That's awesome. We still have apricots on every single arm of this tree. I had to tie these back, because they kept smacking me in the face when I would walk here. So I don't want that to happen. And we got some up here, but these are still green. Let me get on the other side. Those are still green. These are turning yellow. So they're almost ready. I wish they were a little bit bigger, but I mean, that's perfectly okay. They're still growing. These guys are pretty big up there. It's just insane. This tree is insane. So yeah, guys. Oh, actually, you guys can see we're gonna have clouds coming in today, so these guys are gonna get a whole lot of nutrients from the rain. And actually tonight we're going to have irrigation, so like the irrigation will fill up the ditch, and I could fill this I could fill all of these raised beds with the irrigation water, which comes from a local lake, which is really great, because then we could have the fish ammonia and the fish fertilizer, basically from the fish poop, to fertilize my plants. So that's great. Okay, so now there's a reason these tomatoes that we're looking at, we've been staring at for a while, are smaller than the other ones. Reason being, they have tomatoes on them already. Every single one of these plants has a tomato on it. That one's red, okay? Well, that one's like orangish, it's almost ready, but then there's one here who is bright red, and he is one of the first tomatoes of the garden. See? That's awesome. I say we pick the first tomato of the garden on camera, right here. Let me pick him. Aha! Look at that, guys. That will set a standard for the rest of the tomatoes we are going to pick out of this garden. Beautiful, beautiful tomato. Let us see how it tastes. I'm just gonna take one bite and then I'm gonna give the rest to the chickens because I feel the chickens need to savor this. Really good. Really good. I actually wanna take more bites, but I'll take one more. Mmm. Okay. Oh, let me show you guys. I forgot to show you guys. I'm gonna leave the tomato there for the chickens. Okay, so here are some more things that are growing that I do not know what they are. Well, actually, I kind of do. Judging from the color of the leaf, I think that's a watermelon. There's one there, and then there's one over there. So that's cool. Each bucket, or each raised bed that I have here, tends to have like two or three of these guys at least. And that's really great because then they could just grab onto the chain link. All right, so here are the squash slash cucumbers that we have. Some of these guys aren't really taking off as much as their brothers. Like the ones in the back don't seem to be taking off as much. That might be due to, well, I think it's mainly due to the sun and the amount of sun that they're getting. But these guys are like monsters. They have so many flowers. Look at these flowers, guys. That's already got a squash on it, guys. Look at that. He's already got a squash that's growing. I'm just gonna let them flower. Continue to flower and flower. I should probably, if I wanted bigger squash, to cut these, but I kind of just want to get some. Look, this guy's got some on him already. That's a squash. So we already have some squash coming in. That's really great. Okay, you know what, guys? I'm just gonna eat the tomato because I feel like somebody's gonna get it if I don't eat it. So I'm. Okay. That was a good tomato. That was a very good tomato. That was probably the best tomato I've ever grown. That was really good. Okay, so I'm excited about getting some of this squash, guys. We have some little, there's a little thing growing back there. You can see right there. Don't know what that is, but it's a mysterious little bugger, and then we'll see what it comes out to. Oh, and then the apple tree. I almost forgot about the apple tree. But how can I forget about the apple tree? It's huge, it's humongous. It's the biggest tree in the garden. It's insane. We're probably gonna crop it. Me and my father, we're gonna crop it and cut off the top and stuff. Just so it doesn't get too big and maybe it could grow out more. And then it'll like shade over us as we're talking about the garden. And then here is the purple plum tree. Okay, so now interesting tidbit about here. You guys know I've always talked about how these things should have fruit, but they shouldn't have fruit, but they do for the purple plums. There's actually one right here. I'd taken a bunch of this fruit off, and then I just, I'd taken it off when it was very small. Okay. Will it continue to grow? Okay, let me see if my camera focus. Focus. Okay. Well, these things get pretty big now, and I tasted one the other day. It legit tastes like a plum. Like, I'm not even joking. They used to be really tart, and I guess because that's because they were unripe. Now they're not tart at all, and they're really good, actually. Looks like a plum, too. My camera would focus. Oh, well. Well, it looks like a plum, too. That's good as well. And there's some more hiding in here. I just haven't gone in and figured where they are. All right, dudes. So we're going to go ahead and talk about the first raised bed of this left side of the garden. Now, this guy has a few new additions, namely some of the seedlings that have sprouted up from the compost. So let's go ahead and count them off because there's quite a few in here and I kind of want to get a count for them. So there's 1, 2, 3, but he's very small so he might not make it. I'm gonna count them anyway. 4, 5, 6, 7 tomato. 8, 9, 10 tomato. So 10 mysterious little seedlings and 2 tomatoes. That's really awesome. Okay. And they're kind of in a good position right there. That's where we had the watermelons last year, and they grabbed onto the fence and they did really well. They're coming a little later than the watermelon did last year, but I think it'll be perfectly fine. Our growing season here is incredibly long. Okay, guys, so now we have the chile de árbol and the cayenne pepper. No, wait. Yeah, there's chile de árbol and cayenne peppers. These guys are doing kind of well. They're not doing as great as like the chilies down there and the chilies over here especially, but they're living. Their leaves are pretty small. That's probably significant of them getting a little bit too much sun in this area. However, that's fine for my uses. You guys want to say hi?
Hi.
Okay. That's perfectly fine, because then as they start to grow older and then the days grow longer, they'll be all right. Once they get accustomed to the actual sunlight, I feel that these guys are going to do great. And then we have the cantaloupes in the middle. So there's that cantaloupe and that cantaloupe. They're doing good too. Okay, so then, we have our apple pear. Now, the apple pears, these fruits don't seem to be growing one bit. I come out here every other day and I look at them and they don't seem to be growing. Obviously they are, because they're attached to the actual tree, but they don't look like they're growing. They're just very, very slow growers. Slow to ripe. And there's only a couple of them on here compared to last year. Well, last year we only had like 6 anyway, so they're doing all right. Okay, so then we have our basil, our ginger, excuse me, our ginger mint back there, and our curled parsley, and then this catnip like took off in the last couple of days. Like, it was just like I come out here one day and it was doing okay, and I come out here the next day and it looks like this and it's overflowing the bucket. Like, this guy's cool. Oh man, what was I talking about? I lost track of, I lost my train of thought. Okay, so orange suns and better bells. The orange suns are kind of dwarfing the better bells. I think that's kind of a theme for my garden, is that the things on the right side tend to be doing better than the things on the left. I don't know if that's indicative of the way that the sun moves across the sky, or, you know, like the stars aligning. I don't know, but it's interesting to think about. You guys can see my little elephant right there. But guys, keep in mind these chilies right here, they do look very, very dense, like they got a lot of leaves, but remember, there are 2 plants here, so like there's 2 stalks, right? But the stalks are, they're rooted in well. Oh, these are all 1. Okay, so these are 2, these are 1. But yeah, so that's that. Remember, guys, I think I told you guys I had some sad news. One of my cantaloupes actually ended up just breaking off from like the stem that was right there, so he's gone, but that one's still doing well. He's doing very well, actually. He's got one arm going that way and one arm going that way. And then we have little friends back here. Hello, friends. There's a couple there and a couple there. Oh, and there's one more right there. I don't know what those guys will be, but they're in the perfect prime, perfect position to grab onto the fence, which is exactly what we want for those types of plants. So that's gonna be great. Okay, so now we have our apricot here. None of the apricots on this tree, although there's only like 6, they don't seem to be going yellow yet. But they're doing well. They're kind of weirdly shaped. Like, this one's kind of shaped like a, I don't know, what would I call you? Like an egg? That one's shaped like an egg. That one's shaped like an egg as well. So that's interesting. Okay, and now back here, guys, that's our lavender and golden oregano, but those are kind of doing meh. All right, guys, so you know how, because I really want to talk about this, you guys know how the mint was doing very, very well. Well, recently, I think it's gotten a little bit too big to handle itself. So what has been happening is it's either been dropping its leaves, something's been eating its leaves, I don't know, but I think it's about time I go ahead and trim this, cut it all the way down, and then we'll see what happens there, because it seems like the leaves have been shrinking in size rather than growing in size. So I think it's about time we just we cut it. Okay, so here's the habanero. Now, this habanero, I want you guys to compare this one to the ones that are over there once we get over there, because you're going to notice immediately this one's a lot bigger. That could be due to a number of factors, but this one's a lot bigger, and I'm happy about that. And then, obviously, we have our grape that was finally able to grab onto the fence, and he's actually continuing to grow. So, that's great. He's able to grab onto the fence. I'm happy about that. So, that means the grape is thriving. It's a two-year-old grape. Okay, now we get to the plum tree. Let me just back up right here. The plum tree is bending. There are so many plums on here. Oh yeah, there you go. You guys can see there. Look at all those plums. They're of significant size. Now maybe it's a little bit smaller than a ping pong ball. Okay, so that's the peach tree. Now here we go onto the New Mexico number 6, the long green chilies. Now, all right, so these guys are doing significantly better than a lot of the other chilies, at least in my opinion. Obviously, this is the special bucket, so I have a very high degree of expectation from this bucket, and these guys seem to be doing very, very well. The reason I'm saying that is because if you guys look at their leaves, very, very wide. This guy over here, although he is two plants, he seems to be consistently showing new growth, at least on the very, very tips right here. And I don't know, these guys just seem to be doing well, except for that one. That one's a little bit smaller. He's a little smaller than the other ones. That's okay. He's still doing well. They seem to be rooted in well. And they're just like in a nice little spot right here away from everyone else. I should probably take off this thing. Should. Probably not. I'm probably not going to. But I probably should. Okay, guys. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to zone 2. Alright, guys. So one of the additions I have for the garden is I've gone ahead and planted a tomato that I found him somewhere in zone 2, right? And I planted him right here in the dirt. I'm going to compare how this tomato does in this dirt compared to the tomatoes in the pots. Okay, because he's already of significant size and he seems to be doing alright. So I just planted him in like the regular dirt that I have here in like my home. So we'll see how that turns out. Oh, and look, we also have another tomato here. I'm gonna let him grow. So hopefully he'll be able to grow and then grab onto the chain link and then just keep on going. But yeah, and now here are the habaneros. I told you guys this guy keeps getting fed something weird. But otherwise, compare the growth of these to the one that was in the bucket over there. The one in the bucket is doing really, 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 really well. But these guys are doing well as well. Alright, so then also, here we have wonderful lettuce leaves. This guy, mysterious lettuce that decided to start growing here. He just took off. He just did his own thing. Oh, geez, I almost forgot to show you guys. Look at, this is what it looks like. Well, I showed you guys last time, but this is what it officially looks like when a onion decides to flower. Look at that. Pretty, huh? There's some more over there. Alright. Oh, let me show you guys. Look, another little tomato. Another little tomato is growing there. All right, guys. Now, here are the fuzzy serrano peppers. These guys over the last, like, week? No, maybe not even week. Just, like, 4 days. Like, I came out one day. They were doing meh. I came out the next day. Boom. They just exploded. So, these guys are awesome. No complaints about these dudes. And we have a little friend right there. All right, I'm going to try and hold my camera in a different orientation. Just bear with me. Alright guys, now here we have the Big Jim, the 10-inch peppers. Ooh, but we also have another lettuce, and that looks like a watermelon. But these guys have just shown like consistent growth for the last couple of weeks. And I'm very, very happy about these plants. I'm very, very happy. They seem to be one of the bigger chilies compared to like those are the hot Fresnos. And those, they're doing really, really well. They're one of the bigger chilies, at least leaf-wise. So yeah. And then we have our tomatillos. Tomatillos recently, guys, have been getting like weird little spots on the edges of their leaves. I don't know what that's indicative of. It's indicative of something though. And there's just a whole lot of tomatillos on here, guys. Look at that. Look at that tomatillo. Okay, dudes, so here we have the Santa Fe Grandes. Now, these guys are barely starting to put on fruit. So I've been watching these dudes and it's only in the last couple of days that these, well, not fruit, I should say, they started to put on flowers. So they put on a couple flowers, not as many as the other chilies, but you know, they still have a couple flowers per plant. So I'm happy about that. These guys have rooted in exceptionally well. They just keep on consistently growing, putting on new growth, and I'm happy about that, guys. So those are the Santa Fe Grandes. And here, dun dun, we have the Chili Super Hots. Now, guys, every single chili super hot plant has a chili that looks like this. Like, look at the size of this. Like, compare that to my finger. It's huge, okay? They're very, very reminiscent. Oh my God, look at how many are there. They're very, very reminiscent of the chile de árbol in the way that they grow. However, it seems like they don't grow in like clusters, They just grow like singly. But we're gonna get so many, guys. You could just see like the dotted little white marks that are just around here. Some of these are barely starting to grow. It's just all these flowers. And then they're gonna turn red, hopefully. They're beautiful, beautiful. These are probably the only ones that have put on fruit compared to the other chili plants. So I expected great things from these plants, and they've given me great things, and I'm very, very happy. There's way too many flowers to start controlling them now. I'm just gonna let these guys do their own thing and just let them continue to grow however they please. Okay, now here we have, what were these? These Tabascos. Okay, so the Tabascos, I've just been watching them. They haven't put on any, they've barely started to put on flowers. Okay, they seem to be very, very slow growing, and I don't know if that's kind of expectant of Tabasco peppers. I've never done them before, so I guess it's just kind of an experiment of us learning about the Tabasco peppers. And then we have here little tomatoes. I don't know what I'm going to do with those guys. I might just leave them. So that's that. Okay, guys. So now onto the piece de resistance. Our giant tomatoes that are growing here in the garden. Okay, so recently, you guys remember, for the first couple of weeks, these guys just, they hooked onto something. They started growing incredibly fast and then, boom, just took off. Over the last week, 2 weeks, they've slowed their roll. They've stopped growing as much, okay? I think they're getting a little bit too much sun now for their tastes. So they grew a little bit too fast, and then the days are a lot hotter now. So their leaves are starting to curl up. I think that's because they don't want as much sun, maybe. They've started to put on flowers. So some of them here, they started to put on flowers. I'm happy about that. And then, guys, we'll get to those guys in a bit. But they started to put on flowers. And hopefully we can start getting some production out of these guys instead of just, you know, full-on growth. But you guys could see the, kind of how they kind of ramps up like that. These guys are a little bit bigger. Okay, we'll get to those guys we'll go over. Okay, so these are like the yellow crookneck squash. You can see it starting to grow right there. The plant itself is very, very small here. I'm probably going to take off some of these. Yeah, I think I'm going to take off a couple of these flowers just so we could divert a little bit more production into some of the squash and then the plant itself. It's very, very small. But here we have a cucumber. Guys, our first cucumber. Look at how cute is that? That's our first cucumber. Because I came out here the other day, I was wondering, like, why is this guy very, very small compared to the other ones? Because he's very, very bunched up. And I realized, well, he's got a cucumber right there. So that's very good. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and go on to the tomatoes and the mysterious little thing I have growing there. So these guys, remember, I saved them out of the zone 2 garden beds. So out of all the beds, really, they've just been around here. And I saved them, transplanted them, and they seem to have taken a very, very well, a good liking to all of these little buckets. Some of them more than others. So like this guy really likes it, but these guys are kind of doing all right. And then this guy, he's liking it. Look at the size of that leaf. This is the one that busted through the tomato that was on top of him, killed the tomato, and then just started sprouting out. So that's great. And then here we have a tomato accompanied by some watermelons. I could tell that these are watermelons, and this one isn't because the leaves. Watermelons have leaves that are kind of like hoof-shaped. Well, not hoof-shaped, but like weirdly shaped like that. And then this is something else. It could either be like a cantaloupe or a pumpkin or something. There's some more. See, that's not a watermelon, but that one is. You see? See the difference? And this guy has a friend, and I just put him in a couple days ago with a special little pot. And then, guys, we have, our parsley. No, not parsley, cilantro. That's gone ahead and just given us a whole bunch of pretty flowers. And also, 3 patio tomatoes and our first patio tomato. I'm going to go another little one under it. I'm gonna go ahead and pick these guys tomorrow. I'm gonna pick them tomorrow. So that's it, guys. That's it for the garden update video of May 13th, 2016. There's a lot of cuts in here, guys. My camera keeps overheating. I'm sorry about that, but otherwise, these plants are gonna get a well-needed rain, hopefully tonight, because the clouds are rolling in. Well-needed rain. We're gonna get some irrigation in the ditch in the next couple of days. So I'm gonna, you know, hopefully irrigate this entire area with a lot of the fish ammonia and fish poop that comes from the lakes and stuff. Very, very good water in comparison to what I'm feeding them now. So these guys are just gonna take off by the next time you see them, guys. This is gonna look like a completely different garden, I assure you that. Oh geez. Alright, so I hope you all enjoyed, and you know, man, guys, the garden's just, it's so great. I'm just so happy about the garden. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the garden tours, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.